This is Kingston Road, Logan City, a major road that crosses over what seems to be an insignificant and utterly dirty creek. Like many, I've driven to work every day over this creek for years without giving it a second thought, until one day, I decided to take a closer look and I hiked the entire creek line from start to finish. And what I discovered absolutely blew me away. This 35-kilometre creek system proved to be one of my most interesting explorations yet, and all in my own backyard. This is the journey of Scrubby Creek. Once again, gonna be heading out for another leg of Scrubby Creek goodness. Maybe my final leg, we'll see.
Got everything?
Yeah.
All right, catch ya, see ya.
This is where I'm gonna be taking it today, in the midst of the hustle and bustle of Logan City. This is a part of Scrubby I've been a little bit unsure about, to be honest. Well, I've been unsure about all of it, really, but this is the part that's kind of had me a little bit concern, and I don't really know how I'm going to go today, because the plan for today is to start here at Queens Road. We're going to be bush bashing it down this segment that goes all the way along Loganlea Road and goes down to Nujooloo Road. This part of Scrubby meets up at Slacks Creek. This will be the intersection. My plan is today to actually go up on a segment I'm very unsure about. I don't know if it's private property or not, but it goes up behind the Meadowbrook Golf Course and up behind the TAFE, I think it's called Southside TAFE or something like that, here at Meadowbrook and Griffith University. So that's going to be very interesting, and if that goes to plan, this will be the end of my series. Logan City Council, 1996. This indicates when this bridge was actually properly opened up. This is an area of Scrubby that always flooded up until the construction or the rebuilding of this road to that height. This was a previous road, the original road. I remember driving here with my parents as a kid. Today, our mission is going to be to navigate through this segment of Scrubby down here. So what I need to do first is actually set up my hat. I'm just kind of having a little look and a think about how I'm going to tackle this, and I think I may actually tackle it through this side possibly. So anyway, let me get my hat on and my rig all set up and let's do it. Enjoy the bush bashing adventure. I saw a little slight game trail up here, and this is where we might make our start. Now, this is going to be rough as, I reckon, so it's going to be very interesting. I can already see it's swampy, it's wet, but that's Scrubby. And already straight up, there's like a little oasis here. And once again, a reminder, you could come here and just have your little cup of tea, have your little Tim Tam, bring the kiddies along. I mean, look at this, straight up. Queens Road, the old Queens Road, is right there. You can see the cars going past, and just only 100 meters in, there's already like this oasis area here. It's
amazing.
The beauty that is just a stone's throw away, and the beauty of a crappy old bucket. So as you can see, I've got some really thick grass here to negotiate. The creek is off on my right, the grass is just way too high. So I'm going to try to find like a slight little game trail, and this looks like something I'll push through. Got my spider web breaker, because there's quite a few. Oh, here we go.
It's a bit sketchy this long.
All right, that was a bit dodge. That was pretty sketchy. Lot of long grass here, so don't know if I can come down this way. All right, so the creek meanders its way down over here, which is towards a little bit the western side. Just heard a water dragon jump in. It's walking on this tree branch that's covered by grass, so I can't see where I'm stepping. Oh, there we go, solid ground. Here we go, scrubby. And just look how tiny it is. So here we're talking, you know, 2.5 meters wide. That's thick as, far out. Trying to go over here a little bit more on the, hopefully the easier side. It's just thick as there, so let's push on past here. Oh, this is nice. Apart from the spider webs, this is really beautiful. Even though it looks like a complete mess, there's just a distinct beauty, isn't there? Yeah, with all the fallen logs, there's just something that's so untouched about it. Oh, hang on. Look at this. Growing here in the middle of scrub is a lemon tree. Look at this. You can just see the trail left by wallabies. And who knows what other kind of creatures, yowies. And that was a pretty tough section I just did there, like rugged. I've finally broken through some serious bush just to this section here. So just up on the right hand side of me here, as I'm just traveling sort of north, is a park area called Slacks Creek Environmental Park. Now that's just a bit of a circuit. It's on the backside right there. Oh yes, here we go. Log crossing. I think I'll just stay on this side still. That's kind of a log to nowhere. Oh, look at this nice little alcove. Place of the Tim Tam. Find serenity now. Look at this, it's beautiful. All I can say is wow. Looks like there may have been some fence line here. Maybe these are old fencing posts. Right here. Right there. Now that's quite a stretch of scrubby there, isn't it? It's probably the straightest run I've seen. So just back there, where Queen's Road begins, to this point here, and I've only gone just over a kilometer. That was probably the gnarliest section, like it was rough as guts. But then you come to this part, and if you have a look up on my left hand side, up on the other side of the bank, just filled with peeling paper bark trees. It's quite nice, isn't it? I love that. That just looks amazing. However, it is spiderweb city. I'll tell you right now. I don't even want to think about all the arachnids that are crawling over me right now. Cast it out of my mind and just deal with the task at hand. And that is to follow this amazing creek system. Noticing this big long pipe just up ahead here. Just have a look at this thing. This pipe that goes across. This is the longest crossing. It's not a log crossing, it's a pipe crossing. I may as well begin right here where it starts. To me, this looks like it's about 60 meters long. I mean, certainly doable, but far out, it's slippery. This is slippery. I don't know what it is. I've just suddenly been sketched out. Come on. I don't know what it is. I've just been sketched out. I feel so stupid. This is like the silliest thing ever. I don't know why. Suddenly I lost my ability to walk across this thing. Although this is fun. That was like the weirdest thing. I have no idea. Right at the last second, I got sketched out and then bum crawled my way across this thing. That's so embarrassing. I don't know if I'll show this. A beautiful pathway. Bunch of horses over there to my right. Straight over there with the horses looking at me, that's Nujooloo. Nujooloo Landscape Center off Loganlea Rd. Oh. Rubber tire if anyone needs one. I'm surprised it's not in the creek. Getting much closer to the merge with Slacks Creek. Loganlea Rd, just over there, you see all the cars that go past. I've come to an interesting part of Scrubby. Now, what it does, it diverges here slightly before it hits Slacks Creek. Now, over here, straight up ahead, that's the M1 motorway overpass, just before is Nujooloo Rd. And there's a bridge. We're going to be going under that bridge. However, Slacks Creek just is down there. But Scrubby Creek does an interesting thing. It goes down to Slacks Creek. I could do that. But it also wraps itself up and around here. But I want to just follow this little course of Scrubby just before hitting Slacks Creek. As it wraps itself around and hits Slacks, and then we'll go back up. So in case if you do look at my GPS trail on Wikiloc for this section, this is Scrubby Creek right here according to Google Maps, and it's a water course that loops sort of back and around. Now it's dry as a bone right now. Oh, this is nice place of the Tim Tam with your little cup of tea. Here we come across to some serious marshland. I can see the football fields just up on the other side. I think that's called Meekin Road. Oh, that's swampy. Holy moly. Okay, that's right. We'll just keep pushing over here. Here we go. Here's the other section of Scrubby. And we'll just follow this down. Another nice place for a Tim Tam, isn't it? All right, starting to get a bit wet and mushy over here. Hey, by the way, if you're ever in such a place, these make for perfect fire starters. Perfect, absolutely great. Just get a little bit of a flint, couple of sparks of that and woof, that's your fire. If you're ever gonna get stuck and caught overnight at Scrubby, you've got a couple of fire starters here, you know, you can use in the marshland.
Just watch it, you don't set the whole place on fire. Here I am walking like a lunatic and a freak, and I'm kind of lucky because right at this point there's a place for the public to sit down and have a look at. It's right there. It's a park bench. People sometimes come here and look out. Could you imagine?
Could you imagine if they're sitting there and then suddenly they see this weirdo walking through here? I don't know what they'd be thinking. They'd be calling the cops, 100%.
So folks, this is it. This is Slacks Creek.
I'm wrapped. This is good. So this is Scrubby Creek. It's come all the way down here and merges with Slacks Creek.
I'm hearing all of these water dragons that's jumping in all around the place, and you can see their ripples. Quite sandy this stretch, isn't it? Look over here.
Congratulations if you've stuck with me. We've done Scrubby Creek. Let's head up Slacks Creek. This is the part that's got me sketched. I really don't know how far I'm gonna get, if I'm gonna be chased down with pitchforks by golfing clubs, by the golfers, or whatnot. We're gonna see.
As we go straight up and further up, we are going to be going under the bridge just before Nujooloo Road. Someone's left their motorbike right there. What is the go with that? Can I just say, this is some of the thickest and highest grass I've come across. Oh. There's a reason why people don't come for a walk along Scrubby. And this is one very good reason.
Oh, here we go. Whew. That's hard yakka.
Look at that. And you can see the bridge just before Nujooloo Road. So here is the other, you could say this is the real intersection, Scrubby, as it marries up with Slacks Creek. Loganlea Rd, JJ Richards truck driving past.
Right. There's no easy way to do this. I've just got to punch on through. And I've just got to make a decision now which side I'm going to go. I think I'm going to go over on this bank. Yeah. Righto. And I tell you what, I've always wondered about this spot, what's on this side. You keep seeing it from the motorway, but you never, I've never made the effort to come down here. Why would you? Oh, wow. Wow, indeed. Okay. Amazing. Oh, it's a water pumping truck. That's what it is. Whoever thought that was here? Right. There's a slight walkway here you can see that goes under the bridge. Here we come across a basketball. So
There's the Nujooloo Bridge, as I'll call it. And this is Slacks Creek. Now, this is a part I've always wondered about. There's an equestrian horse place just up there. So it looks like that's all private property up on the left-hand side. So I'll stick to the right hand here, which I'm not too sure about, to be honest, but hey, at the end of the day, we're just going up the creek line. No harm, no foul. Oh, there we go. Look, look. Did you see that? That went for about 5 meters across the water, that water dragon. Oh, man. That's pretty cool. That was a real close-up. Oh, wow. Looks amazing. This is Slacks Creek, folks. Slacks Creek. It's quite muddy around here, but you can see it's not a very deep creek, this one. So I can see Slacks Creek widens right out here, and there's all houses up on that side. So we're sticking over to this side where there's no houses or anything here. So this was a section of Slacks Creek I was really unsure about. What am I going to come across here? But it's beautiful. Got the ducks just down here. The stream just continues going up straight. And in case you've ever driven down Loganlea Rd, and sort of opposite New Way Landscape Center is sort of this all overgrown farming land with some decrepit old fallen down sheds. I think this is the area that's behind those old horse sheds. Oh, looky here. Here we have the congregation of the ducks. I think I see an ibis. Yes, it is. Oh, there we go. Watch this. The water dragon. It's going to run. It's right there. Can't believe it hasn't jumped yet. There it goes. Come on. And I've just come across another ball. So much land back here, you know. Problem is it's all flood prone. I want to see if there's any point where I can cross over. Keep your eyes peeled, peeps. Ideally, I'd like to go on here and then continue up over there. Otherwise, I've got to go all the way around. Anyway, let's have a look. There's a bunch of trees falling across. I may be able to get across one of them. Here we go. We're coming up to some big log. It's going to be my crossing, I reckon. Okay, so I've made it across to the other side. So the creek actually, what happens with it? It meanders all the way down, up and around there. I just crossed over that tree like a big baby. It goes around here, and then down to this side over here. So we're just cutting our way across and just saving a little bit of time and distance. It's going to start going and working its way up and around the golf course. So yeah, pretty fascinating stuff here for me. Yeah, always wondered what's over on this side. I can see already there's horseshoe prints, hoof prints. This is horse territory. And this is just all farmland, just for horse grazing. all around. So much land, it's not funny. And there's the golf course. Straight over on the right. Just wondering how much mud my feet can step into. But we're going to be coming across a lot of golfers here now. And I can already see them. They're in their golf buggies because they're too lazy to walk it. And there's a big power line grid that runs across this section. Now I'm going to try to keep a little bit more out of sight of the golfers, not to freak them out. So, but we'll see. I really don't know what to expect over here. So coming to the backside of some property here that's got some electric fencing. Don't know what it is they're trying to grow. So I'll try to move a little bit more promptly over here. So we're coming to a wider section here. I don't know if I can go across or what the go is. Ideally, I want to jump onto that side, so it's back of the golf course, but I have to get across somewhere here. All right, let's just get down here. I feel so dodge going on this section of Scrubby. I'm contending with golfers over there, don't know if they've spotted me yet. And then the low side of properties. Properties that are over here, and there they go. The golfing duo, there's two golf carts. Just trying to get along this section of Slacks Creek as quickly as I can. Unfortunately, I can't take the time to enjoy things here. All right, comes a section that I'll have to run. Okay. Whew. So far, so good. So I'm just being careful here because I can see private property there. I don't want to be trudging over there land if I can avoid it. Where I do want to be trudging is over there. I think I might swim my way across. I'll go over there to the rocks. So let's go in. I don't know how deep this goes. This is it. That was a very bad idea, but anyway. It went a whole lot deeper than I thought it would. My phone went under twice. Hey, my phone still works. It says no SIM. So the water must have affected the SIM card somehow, but hey, it still works. So if I do that again, I'm gonna have to do something different. No, one of my hands went under and I chose the phone rather than the GoPro.
Right, I think I've come to Leslie Parade Park. What a trip. Absolutely saturated, but I think, you know, as I keep going along, unless if I jump through any other pools, I should, you know, start to dry up, except for my sloshy socks and my boots. That moment when your feet go into the water and you've got thick socks and boots, nothing like it. It's the best. And to be honest, I think I'm going to do one more swim.
Kind of have an idea where it's going to take place, more towards the end of this particular hike.
So yeah, it says this is a nature reserve, so I think that's an easement that comes up to Leslie Parade somewhere. We're going to follow the creek line now, so we'll continue on through this scrub over here. Righto, this must be the back of some people's properties. So I've pushed on past those houses, and I've come to a very bushy stretch, so this is more like it, sort of not in full view of the backs of people's properties. Yeah, we're still following the creek line, that's the marshlands. It's just a bit too thick to walk there at the moment. I've got ground to walk on now. I can make up for a bit of lost time, which is great. A couple of small makeshift bridges. Just noticing some kind of a there's some tents over there. I'll just let them be in case the hobos are still sleeping. Look, it's the kookaburra. And I'm starting to notice a lot more palm trees. Especially down here, it's a bit more rainforesty. Should be coming up to Slacks Creek. I've kind of cut out a big hairpin turn because there was just no need for me to go down there. It's quite difficult actually. Just such a rainforest feel here. I just saw a black snake. Just didn't get it on camera, but yeah, right in there. So they are around, the snakes. It's spring now and getting warmer. I think they're gonna start to emerge a whole lot more. Hey, I've come up to the other side of these little hobo tents. Pretty rough place to get to for a hobo. I really can't see the point of it. So I'm following Slacks Creek around, but up on the high side there is a bit of a trail, or you can drive vehicles here. It says that it's the Murray Road Environmental Nature Reserve. Another snake. You can see it there, they're just crawling into the bushes. What the heck? Who's this guy? There we go. Just come across an interesting specimen here. Looks like it's from Mortal Kombat. She's rough here, rough as, but this is it. This is Slacks Creek. Golf course is still up there. We're gonna keep trudging along this left-hand bank. If you just look over here, I've just come up to Murray Road. Here we are. This is a road that just comes down from the Hyperdome shopping center at Logan Home. Slacks Creek goes right there. It's probably only about 20 meters in, and perhaps you can see the water. It's right there. It's all mud and sludge there, so I'm not gonna bother going in that. And I think it's just at this point of Murray Road where we're gonna take this offshoot. I think it goes onto farmland once again.
which we're just going to be going on the backside of.
I actually thought coming today on a normal working day, there'd be a whole lot less people playing golf, but man, they're crazy. They love it.
And we can see that the Logan Mogaway is just over there on that side. We've got quite a lot of marshland to navigate through over here, so this would be a tough and rough section.
My mission now is to get to the overpass just over there.
What the heck is this thing? It's a go-kart.
Screw it. I tell you what, this is way better walking on grass than pushing it along that bank. All right, so we can see Slacks Creek is doing another big turn here, and I might just follow this because this is interesting. It goes, there's the golf course. This follows its way around, and it'll go all the way around there and up that side. This is the final resting place of this bed. You get it? Final. I may actually be going for another swim.
Unless if I can find a way that jumps over to the other bank, then I'll certainly be having to swim across,
which actually wasn't too bad, to be honest. But I'll keep my phone, I think, in my hat this time. I think that'll be a better idea. So our journey is slowly coming to an end. As soon as I come to the Logan motorway, the overpass there, and get across, that's it. That's where Scrubby Creek and Slacks Creek, they merge and intersect into the Logan River. And that's the end of this whole creek line.
Righto, we are getting closer now to the river.
The end is in sight, the overpass.
This final stretch is like the worst. Let's go across this little sludgy bit.
All right, so close now, so close. I tell you what, this finale section, holy dooly. Undoubtedly, it's been my toughest segment yet. Lo and behold, we come to some barbed wire. Okay, let's get through and across, and then we're done. All right, yes. And here we go. Final stretch of Slacks Creek. Here it is. So that stretch right there has been my toughest yet, because I'm just trying to be really mindful of, you know, public land, private land, I don't know. And so just going right up along the bank outskirts. But this is where I'm gonna try getting across, and we'll make it to the other side. Happy days. I've tried to be a little bit more smarter this time. I've put my phone into the back of a pocket that I have on the back of my hat. I'll be holding the GoPro as I wade my way across this section of creek. Yeah, this is just pure sludge. So it's very slippery. I've got to be careful, but at least I'll be getting a bit of a wash down. Whoa. A wash down as I go through. I think my plan of attack will be sort of to tackle the route of rocks. I don't know what's over there, but we'll see. This is the final section, the grand finale. Let's do it. So far, so good. All right, I can walk on some kind of boulders. I can feel them. Come on. Almost there. Yes. Woo! Ah. Oh, bummer. Poor GoPro. Oh. Okay. Oh. Oh, wow.
There's a bit of a memorial here, over there. And
the same guy's name is up here. John Joseph Babe Bolton. 14th of November, 2018. Poor bloke, he was a truckie. He was driving up, I think he was driving eastbound, and his truck actually came off the bridge. And he was stuck there for a number of hours with severe injuries. I think it was at least a day or something before it was even discovered where he was, which caused him to die, you know, like a day later. He was stuck in the truck, no help, no nothing, and he passed away. Very tragic. So there is a memorial plaque there for Joseph Bolton. So we've come to Riverdale Park. And I'll show you the exact spot where Slacks Creek merges out onto Logan River. It's pretty much the end of this journey. Good thing is, I'm only about, I don't know, 6 or 7 kilometers from home, and I'll be running back. I've done 11 and a half Ks on today's trek. I've been at it for 3 hours and 50 minutes. So coming close to 4 hours, so it'd be about 4.5 hours by the time I get home. Anyway, I'm Satch, and I had so much mud on me, but if you look, it's actually cleaned me up really, really, really good. I don't even have to wash these pants when I get home.
And this is it. This is really it. This is the merge of Slacks Creek with Logan River. This is where it all happens, folks.
This is where all the action's at.
You see people have been trying to do some sort of crab pogging down here. Okay, here you go.
Let me go up there to the park bench and get a better view.
Creek connections, where Logan River joins Slacks Creek. You're witnessing a bigger story.
Whew. A seemingly insignificant creek line had joined up with another major creek line and merges into the biggest river system in Logan City, the Logan River. So this has probably been one of my best hikes, if you can call it a hike, exploration. I've absolutely loved this, and this is something you just won't see. I haven't seen anyone do this kind of thing, and that's not the reason I do it. I do it because it's something exciting, so close to home. It's a world within our world which we're just unfamiliar with because we don't take the time to explore it. Yeah, it's rough. It's rough as guts, but how amazing was it, you know? If you've stayed with me on this whole trek, I really appreciate it, and thank you so much for watching these videos. All of it's been great, but there's definitely been some segments that have just been so much more rougher than others, especially today. That last section, just before I jumped into that water, whew, that was tough. That was tough, but worth it, 100%.
That's all been fun. It's all been good fun. So this is it. Let's make a move and get going. And thank you so much for watching this. Catch you on the next couple of adventures.